views in 24 hours.
He beat out Taylor Swift.
Oh, that's Taylor Swift crazy. Has been dethroned. Oh, boy. Hey, everybody. Welcome to week 4 of The Pop. I'm your host, Sarah.
I'm Charlie.
And I'm Moises.
And we're back and with more than ever. Like, literally, we have so much to talk about, guys. So much. And since we're going to be gone over break, we got to catch up. So let's start off with some new releases. We have The Pains of Growing, Alessia Cara's sophomore album. The 1975 dropped The Brief Inquiry into Online Relationships with 2 music videos, and that was great. Championships by Meek Mill, some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt. Thank You Next, the Ariana Grande music video. Charlie, I see you.
I see you. Yeah, I mean, I think this is going to be a big topic today. This was a huge release.
Yeah. How do you feel about it, Moy?
I freaking loved it. So good. Yeah, there was so much hype leading up to it, too.
Yeah, she dropped the trailer on Twitter and was like, okay, all right, we see you. And she just kept tweeting stuff.
Yeah.
You know, sprinkling her, like.
Such a tease. I was so excited.
Ari. Breaking news, though. Okay, so literally just last night, Cardi B, I was up at 1 a.m. looking at Instagram, and she had posted something on Instagram, a video, breaking up with her long-term boyfriend, baby
they
daddy.
They were married. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It was like they kept it a secret for a little bit, though.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. No, actually, like.
So much is going on.
Did she get a prenup, or did he get a prenup? I'm concerned. Got questions asked.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so Cardi B and Migos from Offset are off. Set. I hate myself. No. That was terrible. I'm so bad.
And then there was her little Instagram moment that you showed me earlier.
She posted a video, and what was she wearing in that? Charlie, care to tell us?
Nothing.
Yeah, absolutely nothing. It was fantastic. You know, everyone loved it. And that's the typical Cardi B style to go off in a relationship. Just post an Instagram video of you topless. yeah. In other words, Nick Jonas and Priyanka Chopra are married. They wed in Mumbai, and they had 2 separate ceremonies.
I thought that was really nice.
Yeah.
Like, to kind of bring those 2 families together in that kind of way.
The 2 different cultures and the fact that they didn't neglect one and, like, either whitewash one or just completely neglect the other. They welcomed both of them. I felt like that was really nice of the Jonases to do and of Priyanka's family as well. And how do you guys, did you guys see, like, any, like, good photos? Do you want to talk about that? People Magazine was the lead press, I guess. And Priyanka had a 70-foot-long veil.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, yeah, I saw a picture
I saw the pic of that.
Elongated. It went forever.
Yeah, like, how? I wonder if it was, like, detachable.
Yeah. I wonder how long she had to prepare to carry that thing down there.
Oh, yeah, was it heavy? No, wasn't it, like, 5 guys that were carrying it for her? It was insane.
Jeez.
Yeah, it was, like, can you imagine?
And then all of Twitter, like, cried.
Yeah.
I'm not saying with Twitter, though.
I mean, Nick Jonas is married. A lot of girls are upset.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of dreams are over. A lot of people are. Yeah.
Darn.
Stan Twitter, we're here with you. Our prayers and thoughts and prayers are here with you. Please reach out to us. All right. In other words, the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show, that was this week. We had Halsey, Bebe Rexha, Shawn Mendes.
We all love a good Shawn Mendes moment.
They're all so good.
Yeah, it was great.
Freaking love them.
We liked it, but the show has reached a low. A lot of people criticizing them for their lack of inclusion.
Mm.
And just the ratings are really low this year.
Interesting.
Any thoughts on that?
Was it marketed? How was it marketed overall?
I feel like traditionally, like they've always been doing it.
But also I just feel like, especially, like, our generation, they're just being more, like, conscious of, like, things and, like, being like, hey, this isn't really representative of, like...
Like the Oscars, you know?
Yeah.
Were the Oscars too white? That was a couple years ago.
Right.
So people are definitely getting a lot more woke about things.
Yeah. And I think that's great.
Yeah, it is great. And I feel like it's really traditional the way that they're marketing things. Like, it's TV. Who watches TV? Like...
I don't even have cable.
Exactly,
Yeah, like, they probably had all those artists, like... Anyone over like 35, 40 probably doesn't really listen to them, especially my parents and their generation.
Yeah.
They're more likely to watch television. They're not going to know who these 3 artists are. Maybe Shawn Mendes a little bit.
But like, I mean, who doesn't know Shawn?
Yeah.
Who doesn't love Shawn? So I feel like that was just a flop as far as marketing goes and reaching out to the right audience.
Yeah.
And they could have definitely like done a better job at, you know, reaching our generation, per se.
Everyone's still all over Ariana, so.
Yeah.
Thank you, Next is still the hottest topic today.
Do you want to talk about that video? I feel like you're so excited.
Yeah, can't contain himself.
There's just so much to it, and I think it was hyped for all the right reasons. It was four iconic movies were really highlighted in it. Really good artists, really good actors and actresses, like the cream of the crop, like, such a good music video. Kris Jenner, yes.
A special little cameo. And I feel like that brings back the old feel of music videos. Like, how long has it been since we've had a music videos with, like, cameos in it, you know?
It's been a minute.
It broke the record for the most views in 24 hours.
Beat out Taylor Swift.
Oh, that's Taylor Swift crazy. Has been dethroned. Oh, boy.
Can we talk about the little theory that we saw today that you showed me?
Okay. So there's this theory that I really hope reaches Ari. So there's a theory that Ariana Grande killed Troye Sivan in the Thank You Next music video. Charlie, you're geeking.
Well, yeah, you showed me for our meeting today, and it's just so far-fetched and so bizarre, but it also just, like, feels right.
It makes sense.
You know?
It's like, okay, he made some points.
And basically, I'm not going to spoil it. If you want to watch that video, we'll have it linked below, but basically, it suggests that the colors that Troye was wearing and the colors after Ari pushed Troye tell a story of Ariana Grande, like, saving us from, like, all evil and killing Troye. And you just have to watch that video. That's all I gotta say. That's it.
But go watch it if you haven't. It's so good.
Yeah, shameless plug to whoever that channel was. Like, I just wanted to reach Ari, to be honest.
Yeah, maybe we'll reach Ari.
Yeah, she's, like, really interactive and stuff, I'm pretty sure. Like,
oh, yeah, she's so active
on
Twitter.
She's so active.
Mm-hmm. When is she going to tweet me back?
I know.
Right? I want my follow back, Ari.
You're seeing this.
Christmas music. It's ho-ho holidays time. So when is it too soon to play Christmas music?
Should never play it.
What?
I've been listening to it since September. So.
I've never been a fan of Christmas.
Like, once in a while, and then once Halloween's over, it's like, okay, it's acceptable.
Wait. Once Halloween is over, like November 1st, is what you're saying is the beginning of Christmas?
Yeah.
Yeah, but, like, I don't listen to Christmas music. I never, liked it.
Thanksgiving,
it's weird.
Though. Like, you didn't like it?
No.
I mean,
like,
it's a holiday of cultural appropriation.
I think that's the only, like, holiday
you're
we have music for.
Yeah, I mean, you don't really have Easter songs or Thanksgiving songs. That one, was it Rebecca Black had a Thanksgiving song? You guys remember that? Who is the most iconic Christmas, like, artist?
It depends on the generation.
Bublé.
That's true.
Michael Bublé.
Michael Bublé, for sure.
Michael Bublé. Do you listen to Michael Bublé outside of Christmas?
Yeah.
Asking for a friend. Just comment your thoughts below. Who is the most iconic Christmas artist? Let us know. Is it Michael Bublé, Mariah Carey, Justin Bieber? All right, so let's wrap up the year, and let's talk about the top artist of the year, according to Spotify. So, the most streamed artist in the U.S., Drake, Post Malone, XXX, J Balvin. Who?
Who? Yeah.
Who?
Don't know her.
And Ed Sheeran. The most streamed females, and this is actually kind of interesting to me. None of the top streamed artists are females.
What?
And then Ari, for the most streamed females, we got Ari, Dua Lipa, Cardi B, Taylor Swift, Camila Cabello.
That is so problematic.
Yeah. It is. And, like, Drake has two songs on the most streamed tracks, God's Plan and In My Feeling, and Post Malone also has two songs. So, hey, guys, wake up, start listening to more stuff. Thank you. Next.
Yeah, please. Also, get Billboard to say that all artists are both male and female. Female, like, putting female separate than just artists.
Yeah, like, why they feel the need, like, to, like, separate.
But the thing is, I don't think the females even crack the top artists. That's why they're putting them separately.
You think so?
So it wouldn't make sense to put, like, a top, you know, top artist males and then have it, again, top artist males be the same people over and over. So it might be a logistics thing.
Okay.
But yeah, that's what we had for the top of the year. We will see you guys again in 2019. It's been an amazing year. Have an amazing happy holidays. Let us know what you guys listened to this year and comment below what your favorite artists are, Christmas or not. So yeah, that's a wrap, and we'll see you guys soon. Take care.